We are live at the semi-annual Intergalactic Sandwich Championship held every 3 years in Asgard.
Yes, that's taking us 3 years to recover from the Cheeseburger's victory over the BLT in the last championships.
Yeah, of course. That led to controversy on whether or not burgers and ice cream sandwiches are allowed in the competition.
The judges have decreed that burgers are simply too good and ice cream sandwiches as a dessert do not
fall. Hi, I'm Gavin. Oh, jeez. I broke my spine.
Well, according to Webster's dictionary, a sandwich is two or more slices of bread having a filling in between.
I don't think I deserve that.
Wait, what happened to Gavin? Was that a third grader? Be that as it may, the judges have spoken and no burgers and ice cream sandwiches in no area. Tacos don't count either.
In all seriousness, DGS Northfield did have a sandwich competition last year.
Versus the grilled chicken sandwich.
It's good because you get like three different types of food and you can kind of have it whenever.
Okay, Mr. Grilled Cheese, what do you say to those who feel like you feel you have a grudge against Italian sandwiches?
Listen, I mean chicken parmesan, fair and square. And then I came up and I took care of meatball. And you know what? If the Italian sub is meeting me in the finals, I'll take care of the Italian sub too. This is nothing against the fine country of Italy. This is about grilled cheese doing what grilled cheese needs to do, and that's make him money so he can feed his family. Thank you very much.
Okay, fried chicken sandwich and the grilled cheese. This one is going to get intense.
Are you upset that you put fried chicken and grilled cheese in the exact same contest? That was very a bad move, I believe. That was very...
Bacon, egg, and cheese soundly defeats roast beef. It wasn't even close.
We all know the reason that folks turn to the sandwich tournament is the Cinderella stories. Who can forget Vegemite's improbable run to sandwich glory in 1986? This year, audiences are amazed that an unlikely sandwich has made it this far. That's right, the Caprese sandwich has taken down a vegetarian front-runner, the Nutella and peanut butter, and then dashed the dreams of East Beast by soundly defeating the lobster roll. How far can it go? That depends on how much you believe in tomato, mozzarella, and balsamic.
Wait, you changed your name to Mr. East? Could you go back to Toast Malone? Because that might be one of the funniest names I've ever heard. Toast Malone.